So along with the greetings, we will start with today's presentation. We will try to see about the preparation modules, whatever is being given in Ayurveda, and what are the guidelines. We have specific guidelines for the formulations. It's not like I can use anything and everything. I have certain guidelines which I need to follow, and only then it will be of much use. I cannot go at random. I have to be more specific. Then it is more effective. So on that ground, so let us try to interact with certain guidelines. Initially, of course, we have such guidelines, many in scattered in many of the textbooks, but the initial format which I would like to take, or the chief format which I would like to take, is only of that of Charaka Samhita, and I'll be discussing from the chapter of Kalpasthanam, 12th chapter, about the general guidelines and how that can be useful or it can be implied for utilizing it in the formulations, any of the Ayurveda formulations or rasa formulations, and specifically in the conditions like that of Aarogyavardhini, which we are discussing now. So on that ground, so the shlokas, what is being claimed by Charakacharya is very significant. One thing he gives a Phalashruti, that understanding the science, understanding the method of preparation, it's not like you give a sort of a mixture. It's not just like you give a sort of a mixture. The Acharya in a particular textbook, he has given you a set of drugs, and among this set of drugs, it's not something like you take up all the drugs, put up into a Kalva Yantra and just rub it and give it to the patient and crisscross your legs and wait for the results to happen. So many times this doesn't happen, and unfortunately we blame the science, like the textbook proved to be wrong. So this is an aspect which we are considering in a wrong way. Instead, Acharya asks us to take the guidelines of these kinds so that which could be helpful for formulating any of the formulation and also benefit for many of the instances. It could be benefited for many of the instances only because by adopting either of these things, it could definitely increase the potency of the drug. It could double, it could enhance, or the toxic substances, whichever is being added, could be minimized, or the dosage of the drug can be minimized. So many of such factors we will try to discuss today, and we will try to see what we can understand. So on this grounds, what Acharya Charaka in Kalpasthana 12th explains us in the shloka number 48 is Alpasyapi Mahartattvam Prabhutasya Alpakarmata Kuryat Samyoga Vishlesho Kala Samskara Yuktibihi. So what he is addressing us is about the modify to one should modify the potency of the drug from the lower to the higher side and vice versa by combination, elimination, timing, processing, and the method of administration. So by this, what happens, the whole mode of drug action will vary. So by this mode of drug action, by the concept of understanding this particular way, what happens? Alpasyapi Mahartattvam. The drug, even though in small concentrations, acts tremendously in a greater clinical result. Prabhutasya Alpakarmata. The drugs which were highly toxic, by adopting any of these procedures, the toxicity or the unwanted nature of the drug is being minimized. Kuryat Samyoga Vishlesho. And with the combination of adding the drugs or removing certain drugs or eliminating certain properties of the drugs, it can give a sort of a boon. The formulation could be a sort of a boon to the humans, and it can definitely help us in many of such issues wherein it could potentify the drug action. And added to that, he speaks about Kala Samskara Yuktibihi, and how you can achieve this with the proper knowledge of Kala, proper knowledge of Samskara, and college proper knowledge about the Yukti. So Yukti is the ultimate thing. Whatever you do, it's your mind power or it's a way of thinking. So on that grounds, he specifies this shloka, Alpasyapi Mahartattvam Prabhutasya Alpakarmata Kuryat Samyoga Vishlesho Kala Samskara Yuktibihi. This is a very important phenomenon which we need to understand. This is the reason why I always emphasize you people saying that biological molecule what you are preparing, it is specifically tailored for a particular patient. It is specifically tailored for a particular patient. It's not like Mrityunjaya rasa is always antipyretic. It could be amapachaka, it could be jwaragna, it could be svedajanana, it could be of various means. It could be of various means. Similarly, Aarogyavardhini, which we are discussing now. So even this is having a multifaceted. I say Aarogyavardhini is a sort of a divyaushadhi, which can be given in so many disorders. And why it can be given in so many disorders? Why is that a praise called as Aarogyavardhini to this extent? We will be enumerating it today. So on that grounds, with this basic knowledge of the idea, what are those basic things which we need to understand while preparing any of the drug? What are these phenomena which we need to consider? So few of the things what he guides us in the same chapter of Kalpasthana 12th is Yadyena Pradhanena Dravya Samuprasrujyate Tat Samnakaha Sa Yogo Vai Bhavati Iti Vinishchayaha Faladinam Pradhananam Gunabhutaha Suradayaha Te Hi Tanya Ta Anya Anuvartante Manujendra Mivetare. So what he specifies is when a drug is combined with the main drug, the formulation is named after the later one. This is a normal pattern. In such a formulations, any of the prime drug, like here for example, he is quoting as Madanapala, etc. When it is given along with other drugs like Sura, etc., which are considered as a subsidiary ones, the later one follows as the people follow the king. He says the prime drug is very important. The prime drug is very important. In case if the prime drug is of a particular guna karma or the prime drug is having a particular dharma, that particular thing is being followed by all the other drugs of that formulation. All the other drugs of that particular formulation. So for all the rasaushadhis, when I want to imply the same shloka for that of the rasaushadhis, it is the parada. The prime drug is always the parada, Lord Shiva. Always it is the parada, which can be the driving force of any of the formulations. Whether you use the parada in a lesser concentration, use parada in a higher concentration, the driving force of almost all the rasaushadhis, it is the parada. Or the second alternative, if you don't have parada, there are many formulations where you don't add parada, then you have some other drugs which are having yogavahi qualities. Whichever can have a yogavahi quality, those will become the driving forces. Or there are certain other important drugs which are being explained, like you have the Gandaka, you have the Swarnamakshika, so they become the prime sources. Or the other formula is where you don't have either of these drugs. It is up to the doctor. He can make one drug as a driving force. He can make one drug as a Pradhana Dravya, and he can potentify it accordingly and make the whole formulation specifically tailored for a particular person or a particular condition. By which it happens, he will have enormous energy, that the drug will have enormous potency. And here for example in Aarogyavardhini, you have a list of drugs which are being explained, like you have Parada, Gandaka, Loha, Tamra, Abraka, Shilajatu, you have Trikatu, you have Trifala, you have Kotuki, you have Nimbapatra Bhavana, you have all these drugs. The driving force is again the Parada. So here what you need to do is, you want to potentify, that is the chief thing. It is something like there are so many people in the car, and the main will or the main thing is depending on the driver. So Parada is considered one of the synonymous Suta. Suta is a charioteer or a driver. He is a person who takes the drug to the respective place. So on that ground, so similarly in a particular combination, the Suta or the driver of your formulation is the Parada. So what you need to do, give utmost importance that you have a beautiful Parada. Beautiful Parada in the sense, therapeutically active Parada. You need to do the Bhuvukshita Parada. You need to create a sort of Ashtasamskarita Parada. You need to see something like the potency of the Parada is being very high. By giving any of the combinations, by mixing it various drugs, by giving Bhavana, by processing it, by adopting any of the techniques, if you are able to make the Bhuvukshita in the Parada, or you are able to increase the potency by Ashtasamskaras of the Parada, yes, definitely that Parada could become a chief driving force of that particular formulation. And Parada, absolutely it is not possible to explain the guna karmas because it is enormous. It is enormous. It is a best yogavahi. It is sukshma srotogami. It is best rasayana. So this particular drug takes the chief action of carrying or chaining up or linking all the molecules of that particular drug formulation and take it to the target delivery system or wherever the body needs. So to that particular area, the drug is being taken away. So this is called as a driving force, and this is what the opinion of Acharya Charaka in this particular shloka is explaining about. So this driving force should be highly potentiated. Say, for example, you might have asked me, sir, the quantity of parada in Arogyavardhini is comparatively less. The quantity of other substances are high. So will they become the pradhana dravyas? Yes, in case if you want them to become the pradhana dravya, you can potentify them. But always, I say, being a person from the Rasashastra department, the prime importance is to the parada, because the textbooks have praised a lot on parada, saying like it can do the vilinata of all the dhatus, all the minerals, metals, everything, all the gunakarma can become vilina in the parada. So this is one of the top secret what you have in the Rasashastra. He tells there are n number of such shlokas where in various places in the Rasashastra, where he explains one metal gets merged up with other metal, with another mineral, and ultimately all these things get merged up into parada. So in the same way, parada is one such substance which can take away all the qualities of all substances which are being processed with that. And that particular drug or the parada becomes a potentified, and it can be used in various treatment modalities, wherein it becomes a driving force of that particular formulation. So in any combination, wherever I use parada as a component, I try to see I make it bubukshata. I try to see I take the ashtasamskarita parada and try to utilize it in various clinical protocols. Then the drug action is very high, including as that of Arogyavardhini, which we are discussing now. So this is one of the thing. The next phenomenon what Acharya is explaining us is Viruddha Viryam Apyesham Pradhananam Badakam Adikam Tulya Viryam Hi Kriya Samarthyam Ishyate. So even if the subsidiary drug possesses contrary potency, it does not create any obstacles in the activity of the main drug. On the other hand, if the former is similar in potency, the efficacy of the latter is enhanced. So see the way how it is being explained beautifully, where the Acharya is explaining about Viruddha Virya Dravyas. So there are many possibilities, like a particular combination. You have some 8 or 10 drugs being added up into a particular formulation. In that particular formulation, you have certain set of drugs which are a particular virya. They are Ushna Virya. There are other set of drugs which are of Shita Virya. So what he is telling is, there are many formulations where you have a mixture of components. You have Ushna Virya substance mixed up into Shita Virya substances and make a different formulation. So whenever you make such formulations, in case if you want the Ushna Viryata to be increased, then those set of drugs can be made up into that formulation. You can add all the drugs which are Ushna Virya and make a sort of a combination. Then the potency of Ushna Viryatva of that particular drug is being enhanced. But in case if it happens like you have added about certain drugs which are of Shita Virya or some other Viryas there, and even in those conditions, the other Viryas are not going to hamper the Ushnatva of that particular drug, because they are not going to contradict each other. Instead, they will support, or they will be balanced. So this is just for the phenomenon to understand, like the drugs might not contradict each other. You can have whether can we mix these two drugs, whether it is possible to mix up. I will say the Gunadharma Siddhanta, analyze it and just mix up whatever drugs you want. So always I emphasize many times, especially to my students, saying like instead of having the combination of drugs, you can definitely have the basmas. You can definitely have lots of basmas, and try to see always you mix up the basmas. Something like a person gives a sort of a mixtures. Might be you can literally name it as a person who mixes the panbida. You know, he adds so many substances into that and he makes one unique combination and gives it to you. So there is no wrong. We can make up all the basmas and keep it aside. Whatever you find it is absolutely essential for a particular patient, those set of drugs can be mixed up in a particular way or in a combination, and then it can be given for the patient. This is how a doctor can tailor himself with the particular drug combination towards his patient. So don't worry about the Ushnatva and the Shita Guna or the Ushna Virya or Shita Virya, because in case if you want to increase, you can increase the potency of a unique way of the Viryatva, or else the contradictory is not observed usually. This is what Acharya Charaka has been explaining us in this particular shloka. And the next thing what he is explaining in the same phenomenon is Ishtavarna Rasa Sparsha Gandhartha Prati Cha Amayam Atho Virudha Viryanam Prayogaha Iti Nishchitam. So in every disorder, because of the consideration of the agreeable color, taste, touch and smell, the use of the drugs contrary in potency is almost certain. So this is very common, that because you need to analyze the other guna dharmas of that particular drug. We need to analyze the other guna dharmas of the particular drug, and we need to mix up them. We have to mix up. You cannot say like certain drugs are Ushna Virya and certain drugs are Shita Virya, so they contradict. Certain set of drugs are Madhura, other drugs are Tikta, though they need to contradict. No, nothing like that. When it is a combination, the efficacy is something different. When it is a combination, the efficacy is something different. So on that grounds, we can definitely make it. So whenever you give these combinations, as I said previously, if not in a particular combination, as you see in case of Arogyavardhini, in any other combination, you give a set of drugs which are being mixed up and you ask your patient to take it. One thing what you can do is you can tag it with a suitable anupanam. So this is what is there in your hand, because you might say like the drug is not being processed in a particular way. I thought something like in Arogyavardhini, I have the Nimbapatra Bhavana. So the potency of the Nimbapatra is also being attributed to the prime drug or to the combination of Arogyavardhini. But here it happens like, in case if you don't have, and I happen to mix up all these drugs with me, the probable thing which I can do, if not an equivalent efficacy to the moderate efficacy to that particular, aiming this particular target, what we can do is we can definitely give the substances in the form of anupanam. Anupanam is another way. So Ayurveda is a very beautiful science which has given us so many steps of potentifying the drug, so many steps to potentify the drug. We have started to adopt the therapeutics into the drug action right from the shodhana of a drug. So in the form of shodhana, we try to utilize the drug which is being used for the therapeutic efficacy. As I told you the other day, the examples related to Shilajato and Gugulu, in case if I do shodhana with Dashamula, it is a Shofagna. In case if it is two Trifala, it is Sroto Sramsana and Vatana Lomana. If the Shodhana is done with Kshira, then it becomes Rasayana. If it is done through Gomutra, then it becomes Lekhana. So every step in Rasa Shastra, every step right from Shodhana, it is clinically oriented. It is on the grounds of therapeutics. Next you do Marana, Abrakabasma Marana with that of Kasamarda Swarasa. It is said to be best Kasa Shwasagna. Abrakabasma with the means of Erenda Patra Swarasa and Buddha, then it is one of the best Vata Vyadihara. So you can design yourself. You can design yourself the protocol, and you can just make a new formula or a new molecule which can be fitting for your patient. So the textbooks like Ananda Kanda and the other textbooks have also been permitting us to use any drug for Shodhana and Marana. It is only a guidelines what has been given in the textbook that you should do with a particular drug. Might be it is a lemon, might be it is Kumari, might be it is with Gomutra or Kshira. But you can do this particular procedure with any drug you know and which is clinically effective for that particular patient can be adopted. So even you have such drugs for Shodhana, you have such references for Marana as well. You have such references for Marana as well, wherein you can potentify the end product based on the therapeutic index, and that of the prime drug can be altered. So this is also one such phenomenon. Then once a Shodhana and Marana is over, next what you do? You do Amrutikarana of the drug. So in Amrutikarana, what are you doing? You are cross-assessing yourself whether you have done it in a proper way or not. You have done the Bhasma Siddhi Lakshanas, there again you have cross-assessed yourself and even potentified the drug further. In Amrutikarana, you are making it Amruta Tulya, because the Phalashruti in Amrutikarana is explaining as Avashesha Dosha Nirharanartham. So whatever in case with or without your knowledge, there are some Avashesha Doshas in the end product. So those Vishas are being removed. Those avashesha karmas or avashesha gunas, which are untowards towards the patient condition are being removed by the means of Amrutikarana. So even this has become therapeutically active. They are not only drug designing. We are being totally collared with a sort of a modern science. So we consider like Rasashastra is a non-clinical department. Every step, every shloka of Rasashastra is clinically oriented. Whenever I speak of Abraka Shodhana, it is clinically oriented. Abraka Marana, it is clinically oriented. When I speak about the Tamra Amrutikarana, it is clinically oriented. When I speak about the Anupanam, it is again clinically oriented. So in Anupanam, what do I do? Whether in Anupanam, either I can give it to reduce the toxicity of a particular drug, reduce the Tivrata or Ushnata of a particular drug, or I can potentify it based on the Roga. So even there, many of the Acharyas has given Balakaladi Apekshaya. You have to answer, proper dosage has been definitely been prescribed in any of the formulation. But in the end, he is asking us to go for Bala and Kala, and that you can fix up the dosage. So even the dosage fixation is also clinically oriented. Every step in Rasa Shastra or in the Rasa text is clinically oriented. So these are a few of the combinations, and this is what Acharya Charaka is asking us to follow in this textbook of Kalpasthana, 12th chapter. The next thing what he is spelling is, what he is addressing us is about Bhuascha Esham Baladanam Karya Swarasa Bhavanehi Subhavitam Alpamapi Dravyam Syad Bahu Karma Krut Swarasai Tulya Viryairva Tasmat Dravyani Bhavayet. The main drugs should be further potentiated by impregnating them with their own juices, because even a small drug, if impregnated well, exerts multiple action. Hence, one should impregnate the drugs with their own juices or the juices of the other drugs similar in potency. So this is very important phenomenon. This is very important phenomenon where you need to understand the situation and see the way how it is being explained. Say, for example, I would like to take it in multiple ways. This particular shloka, I would like to take in many ways. We'll take the example of Arogyavardhini itself. Specifically, of course, the clinical indications are many. Many clinical indications are there. I expect a sort of a drug designing with that of Arogyavardhini, where I would like to prescribe this particular drug for the endocrine disorders, or where I expect a sort of a virechana in action, or where I find something like dosha nirharana as an action. So what I do, one thing, I take drugs like Kumari and give bhavana of Kumari to all these drugs individually. I am not saying like to mix up all the drugs and give Kumari bhavana right from the beginning. Say, for example, I take Parada, I give Kumari bhavana to Parada. You have a shodhana of Parada with that of Kumari. So you do in that particular way. And then the drug is being added into Arogyavardhini, then that particular Gunakarma of Kumari is also being attributed to the mercury there, and that is being an ingredient into Arogyavardhini. This is one sense. This you can do for any drugs in any combination of drugs you have. The second thing what you have is, say for example, you have Trifala as an ingredient in this particular combination. I give Trifala Bhavana to Trifala for n number of times, maybe it is once, twice, 10 times or whatever the number of times you want, so is the potency of the drug, and that particular Trifala Churna is being added up into the Arogyavardhini or any of the combinations, for instance. So this is also one more method of how it is being added. This is also how it is being added. I know many people, so what we do, you have a preparation called as Nagarjuna Braras. So there we are taking Abraka Basma, and for Sahasra we put Abraka Basma, we are giving Arjuna Bhavana. Arjuna Bhavana, as per the textbook, is said to be for 7 times. But many times we see there is a tremendous response in the cardiac illness by administering the Nagarjuna Braras. When you give Bhavana of Arjuna Kvata for 21 times, we have given it even for 100 times. So it makes it more and more potentified. Either of the similar potency or of other potency, whichever you find it is clinically active, should be added. Should be added. So whenever we are preparing the Pottali Kalpanas, I am prescribing, even though it is Rasagarbha Pottali or Hemagarbha Pottali, whatever it is, maximum I am giving these Pottalis in the malignancy cases. So what I am doing in malignancy cases, I need the therapeutic action as that of Lekhana. I need something like anti-gulma properties. So what I am doing, I am giving it भावना विद दैट ऑफ कुमारी, आई एम गिविंग भावना विद दैट ऑफ कांचनारा, आई एम गिविंग भावना विथ त्रिफला, सो आई एम गिविंग भावना विथ मंजिष्ठ, सो आई वॉन्ट टू सी द ड्रग एक्शन टू बी पोटेंसिफाइड और स्पेसिफाइड और डायरेक्टेड इन अ पर्टिकुलर वे, देन आई गो फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर ड्रग एज अ भावना सब्सटेंस फॉर द फॉर्मुलेशन एज सच. यू कैन डू इट फॉर इंडिविजुअल ड्रग, यू कैन डू इट फॉर द फॉर्मुलेशन एज सच, एंड देन वी मेक ए पोटली एंड गिव इट टू द पेशेंट. Then we make a potali and we are giving it to the patient. The response of that particular potali is 100 times more differed from the regular method what is being explained in the textbook. It's not like to say the textbook is wrong nor I am wrong. It is a yukti what we can utilize with the bhavana dravya, and it can totally change the module. It can totally change the module. The mode of drug action is being altered. By this it happens like the whole of the combination of the drugs, whatever you have added, it is being tailored as per the requirement of the patient's condition, as per the patient's condition. So this is what we are doing. These are the various measures which the textbook is giving us. So this is one such a phenomenon this shloka can be interpreted. The another way what we are doing the addition of the substances into the combination. Say for example, we'll go back to the same combination of Arogyavardhini, wherein the first prime drug for me is the parada. That is the driving force of the whole combination. Why I speak a driving force is you can do one small test. There is no harm. Instead, while doing this, you take one set of Arogyavardhini. You don't add a parada into that. You mix up all the drugs which are being explained in Arogyavardhini, make it in the form of some other drug, might be Arogyavardhini grade B, and give it to the patient. And in a grade A or the other, the classical method of Arogyavardhini, where you are adding parada as per the textual norms and give it to the patient, you find a clinical difference. I'm least bothered about what happens in a XRD, XRF or a CM by adding mercury, by not adding mercury, what are the standard norms there. My main attitude is how can I understand it clinically. If the drug is tremendous, if the drug is acting clinically in my patient, I am least bothered about anything. I don't want the drug to be showing a sort of a toxic symptom. I don't want a drug to act as having some side effects or untoward effects, or the drug is not acting in the patient. Either of these things can be rectified, and we are using these combinations into the formulations of any of the yogas. Then you find the actual response, in the patient, how beautifully the drug will act, what is the importance of mercury, or what is the importance of the driving force which I name. So this is one such thing. The next thing is the way how we mix the drugs. So whenever I speak of Arogyavardhini or whenever I speak of such drug combination, what I need to mix up. So along with Parada, the first component whenever I want it to have a complete molecule, whenever I want to see a completeness in the mercury and its clinical mode, then I would like to add Gandhaka immediately after adding Parada and try to triturate it first and then mix up the other substances. Instead, you would like to see like you want to make Arogyavardhini as more Rasayanartha, or you want to see something like I want to have Arogyavardhini as more Pittarechaka, then you can change your mixing. Your way of mixing can be altered. There what we are doing is once the mercury is being added, say for example I want to have an action like a Srotosramsana or Anuloman action, what I do, first I add mercury to that, I add Trifala Churna and triturate it very well. I triturate it very well for a pretty long time. It doesn't amalgamate, I know that. But still I triturate. The Gunakarma of Trifala is being first linked to the mercury molecules, and then later on I add Gandhaka, I add other drugs one after the other, which is of prime clinically important for me. That drug I add with mercury first and then triturate it. Say for example, if I would have had gold, there are many such combinations where people add gold, Swarna Basma, into Arogyavardhini in many places. Of course, it's not from the textual reference. It's based on the Anubhuta, where it becomes more and more effective and more Rasayanartha. So there my choice could be first adding gold there and then I add sulfur. In case If I want it to be more Pitta rich in action, my combination could be Parada has been first triturated with Katuki because it is having Pitta rich in action. And you have to triturate it well, and then you can add the other Basmas and other Gandhaka and all other drugs. So based on the most effective clinical protocol, whatever you would like to see in the patient, that drug should be mixed with Parada first. And then you triturate the other drugs. But then you add the other drugs. In the last, you need to give Bhavana. In the last, you need to give Bhavana. Ascertain yourself that you have converted it to a total, a compound. Don't allow the free particles of mercury to stay in the end product. This is up to you to analyze yourself. And then you need to add up. If I want the mode of action to be something like Rasayana, then I would like to add the Rasayana set of drugs there. Along with Parada, I would like to add with that of Loha Basma, Abraka Basma, and then with that of Gandhaka, and then mix up with other substances and make a Arogyavardhini. I am not altering any drugs as per the classical textbook. The way of mixing of the drug is the one which I am trying to analyze here. The way of mixing of the drugs I am trying to observe. You will not have any changes in your XRD and XRF reports. You mix either the way, you will not find anything. I many times emphasize like the modern chemistry, what you have, it needs to develop a lot to understand the Rasashastra level of chemistry and analyze the things. It is yet to develop. It is yet to develop because there are many factors which are unsolved, which are mysterious to be understood. But they are therapeutically active. They are therapeutically active. So making it therapeutically active in the sense that there should be some changes in chemistry and which we are unable to identify it, which we are unable to identify it. Because people might say there is no problem like you mix up all the drugs in a single kalva and go on triturating it, it is equivalent because FTIR is showing some alkaloids and XRD, XRF is showing some metals and minerals in a particular combination. I name it as Arogyavardhini and you can give it to the patient. So this is a very vague statement for me sitting in a clinical setup. Sitting in a clinical setup. Instead, my combination could be in the style which I have explained and I am trying to imply this particular technique in most of my patients or my formulations in my clinic and then give it to my patient. Then I find an excellent response. Then I find excellent response. So in case if by mixing it vaguely, just like people mix any of the mixtures, what we call here in South India, we call it as churmuri. Just mix up all substances into one thing and just give it to the person. Then it's really not effective to me. I'm not satisfied with that sort of an Arogyavardhini. I'm not satisfied with any of such combinations of any of the formulations. Forget about Arogyavardhini. Any of such formulations, I'm not happy. So it's always better to use that yukti. You need to use that yukti. You potentify the drug in a proper way and then you can utilize it. And one more thing what Acharya is explaining us is by doing this number of bhavanas of the drug to it, then the end product, the dosage of the end product can be minimized. The dosage of the end product can be minimized. Say for example, people are so much worried. Sir, this basma is given as per the textbook. As we have discussed the other day, Somanathi Tamra basma is to be given as that of Trivalla. So the dosage comes to very high dosage for the human beings of today because we are accustomed to take only half ratti. We are accustomed to take only one ratti. That is the dosage. And even for Arogyavardhini is explaining us to take Rajakola Pramana. We are not prescribing so much to our patients. We are using only 250 milligram. Sometimes some companies are doing it with 125 milligram also. But still we are having response in the patient. So what we need to do is, in case we are unable to give that high concentrations to the patient, you have Nimbapatra Bhavana, give it for multiple times. Or potentify the drug with all these herbal juices for more number of times, by which the end product dosage can be minimized. The end product dosage can be minimized and that can be given to the patient so that it could be much benefited. And even with a small dosage, the patient will respond excellently. So this is what is being required whenever we speak about shlokas of these kinds and try to interpret them clinically and see that they are being acting in the patient in a tremendous way. So with this particular background, we'll try to analyze or we try to understand what Arogyavardhini or drugs combination of these kinds will help us to analyze the clinical protocols, or how can we combat various clinical setups or various clinical conditions by prescribing any drug of these kinds and try to give it to the patient. Try to give it to the patient. And they are definitely having more action. There are many combinations like, for instance, Mrityunjaya Rasa, Tribhuvanakirti, etc., where you have Hingula or mercurial compound, where you have Gandhaka, you have Vatsanaba, you have Tankana, anything. So what I do when I want more of Jwaragna action, for along with mercury, first I triturate Vatsanaba. Then I mix it with Gandhaka and Tankana and then the other drugs. So it becomes more Jwaragna in quality. It becomes more Jwaragna in quality. These are small alterations which can be done. And this is what Acharya is trying to explain us. As Alpasyapi Mahartattvam Prabhutasya Alpakarmata Kuryat Samyoga Vishlesho Kala Samskara Yukti Bihi. So this is how we need to understand the various ways how we can module ourselves the clinical combination of drugs. And this is how it could be clinically impactful.